Alright, and welcome to race number 3 for the Xfinity Nationwide Series. Race number 2 in the series on the channel, as mentioned before.
Alright buddy, coming to the green here.
California for the cup race. We did lose this race.
Are you ready?
For the California Nationwide race, but...
Green flag is out.
We are racing here at Las Vegas. We're starting in the 14th position, so starting a little bit, not really in the middle, not front, just kind of quarter of the way up, I guess.
Side. Still there.
Whoa, baby. This track has a lot of grip in it, otherwise we probably would have gone around.
Still there. Clear all around, all clear. Side.
Very surprised we actually held on to that.
Still there. Clear all around, all clear. Inside.
Man, I do not feel like I can drive this track like I did last time we were here. It's a bit odd. Just gotta hit my marks, I guess. Well,
clear all around, all clear.
Most of the time, I qualify and race in the same day, but actually, it's going to be going away for a little bit, and I wanted to get the intro done while I was away, so that way I didn't have to worry about it when I came back. That could probably be it. In my mind, I kind of been used to a little bit different racing, because I already did the Atlanta truck race. Last race for the Cup Series was obviously California, so that's probably why my thought process going into
clear
that turn was not very good. So we're up to 15th right now, lap 4. Try to get under the 37 here of Baker.
Clear all around, all clear.
DJ Kennington is the 81 of it, yeah. Car feels a little tight. I feel like it could just be a little bit looser. But I can't remember how tire wear was last time we were here. We are running 2x wear, so that will probably play a factor. I did not turn the wheel very far on that exit of the tri over there. The one. And almost got the wall. Probably did a little bit. No damage, thankfully. It's been a little bit of a goofy start here, but we're pulling it back together. I want to go on the outside of DJ Kennington, but he's going to push me to have to go to the bottom.
Outside.
I'm not going to go 3 wide, though.
Clear. Outside. Still out there.
Oh, man. Go.
Clear all around. All clear.
Did not want to go 3 wide. Probably could have made it work. More than likely could have made it work. Just not worth it at this time to do it on lap 7. Baker all at my butt.
Yeah.
Now that I think about it, I probably should have just done it.
Stay high.
We would have been fine more than likely.
Clear.
Yeah, we're gonna just go for
outside.
It now. These two, we don't have time to wait for them to finish whatever it is they're doing there.
Still there. Stay low.
And we're going around Vickers.
Clear. 31. 01.
He's coming up behind us. It's DJ Kennington. I didn't realize the front of his car was way. I was so used to the red rear bumper. It's been a little bit since we've been in a Nationwide car. think it's been at least 3 weeks. So much has been just kind of going on, and so we're a little bit out of our normal rhythm here, but picking it back up. So we talked about in the truck race. I talked about the truck race in California. I didn't really, I think I really talked too much. Maybe I did, and I'm just going to sound redundant here, but about the Xfinity race at California. Did I just hear a bang sound? No. I thought I heard someone wrecking. So, California, we sat on the pole, went to turn one, and we were not in first anymore. Car just was very, very loose, and we ended up falling. I think it was like back to 10th or 11th or something. And, yeah, we had to work our way back up. It took a little bit, but I think it was like 10 to go, and we managed to get the lead back and ended up going on to win that race. So we got a win in our second nationwide start of the season, and then obviously started 14th, and it is to be determined where we finish this race. But I remember in the Cup cars, yeah, from just 2001 till 2007, well, through the 2006 race before it was banked, when we ran at Vegas, we were always, like, real good. Real good. And I think the 2007 Vegas race was our first time outside of the top 10 in the Cup Series. Since the banking, I mean, we used to run the difficulty up as high as 104, 105 almost, and we were fine. Just always had really good setups. Now, for the banked version, it's been a little bit more difficult, but that's not the leader up there. I was like, oh, maybe that's the leader, but we're 5 seconds behind. Who is leading? Greg Biffle and Jeff Burton. Not really a surprise, considering the year and the drivers up front. Up here on Bobby. I'm probably not going to be too patient with him.
Side, clear all around, all clear.
Did not mean to actually give him a shove there. You want to give him a boost, hit him in the right rear. You want to get him out of the way, hit him in the left. Yeah, I was thinking maybe I'll just let a little frustration out of that California race. Give him a little shove here. Get him out of our way. If anybody says anything in the comments about that, I'll have to say, I'm not too good at getting payback. That didn't work so well. So surprised at the amount of grip that there is in these turns. It's probably why it feels a little bit on the tighter side. But I couldn't save the car last year going into turn one and save my life. It seems like on the front stretch there was like no grip, but in the turns there's so much grip. I probably can't even do a donut to save my life in there.
37, 2, 6.
We're about 18 laps away from pit stops. We gotta start making some moves. Just go to the outside of Bobby. I am gonna try to message you. We'll get you another day.
Stay high. Clear, clear.
99 is David Rudiman. And we got Tony Stewart, Kelly Byers, Kyle Busch, Boyers at 6, and then your top 5 in order. Biffle first, Burton, Reagan, Edwards, and Harvick. So many Cup Series drivers up here.
Outside.
Pushing off a little bit, a little loose.
Stay low.
We're good, we're good.
Still there. Clear. Inside.
Don't hit
clear,
me right.
Clear, inside. Clear, all around, all clear.
This, the thing I've been noticing, it's kind of annoying. Oh, good, Josh Perry. I have the Xfinity Series race on, actually. and
outside. Be three wide. Outside. Be three wide. Outside.
Well, that was three spots.
Clear all around.
I don't think anybody there was lapped down. No, Myers, Kyle, Tony. Plenty ahead of us. Yeah, so that's three spots. That should put us up to seventh. Yeah, I have the Xfinity Series race on from actually Las Vegas, now that I think about it. That's pretty cool. It's not often that I race the same track that... Wow, okay, yeah, I'm gonna sound like such a nerd, but I think it's cool. We're racing nationwide at Vegas, and the Xfinity cars are at Las Vegas, so that's kind of cool. And the driver who won the race, Josh Berry, is a driver that I used to race with all the time back in the day. We used to talk on Ventrilo with our friend Travis and a friend of ours over in England. And we used to play NR2003 together. So that's pretty cool. Maybe we can get a win just like Josh did today. And Allgaier apparently looks pretty pissed at Noah Gragson. But I don't know why. And I really can't focus on why, because we got a race to win. But, yeah. Yeah, it is funny, because we used to win this, you know, this is back in, like, 2004, 2005. I think it was, it was 04 or 05. I forget what year it was. I remember Martin Truex Jr. won Busch Series at the time. He won the night race at Daytona. I remember talking to him in a chat a couple days after that. Or it was the next day, actually. I was doing some Daytona night races. I did one with that. He was in it. Denny Hamlin, Mike Bliss. That was pretty cool. It was always really cool when I remember you'd see real drivers popping in open servers. It was always a treat. I remember Denny Hamlin and Mike Bliss in that race. I wish I had the old replays. I remember that race very vividly, though, just because you're racing Hamlin and all that. I mean, Hamlin really didn't have much of a name at the time, but I remember him and Bliss were going three wide, and it wasn't even a BR Daytona night track, and took each other out. But, yeah, going back to when we used to race with Josh, it was NTR, I think it was our old team. I don't remember what it stood for, NASCAR Team Racing maybe or something, but yeah, I remember the news when Josh went to Xfinity Series racing for Dale Earnhardt Jr. I texted one of my friends, Travis, and I was like, yo, do you remember Crazy Carter 7, Josh? He's like, yeah. And I was like, he's racing for Junior. We were like all excited because at the time when we knew him, he was getting into, I think, Legends. And then he got into Junior's late model team, I believe it was. But he always talked about wanting to go racing. He was crazy good at this game, too. And always, you know, he had a ton of talent in the game, always winning races. So it doesn't surprise me to see it translate so well for him. Real life. So he just made it to the final four, so he's who I'm pulling for. So amidst all my jabbering, we have made it up to fourth.
Four.
5.1 seconds back to Greg Biffle. Burton's right with him. David Reagan's falling back from them a little bit. That's him right up ahead. We're about 8 laps away from the pit stops. So we've really got to try to get to the edge of our pit window if we're going to... Because instead of saying it was about 33 laps, well, it's a 67-lap race, so... If we can save just enough fuel to get it onto lap 64, or 34, we can make it on one stop. Cup race, we'll definitely have to make two. If we just go 33 to 66, we'll be plenty good. It's only an 81 lap race, it's only 14 more laps. My line, I don't feel like I've been as consistent as I can be at other tracks. It's just kind of just letting it go where it wants to go. Sometimes it wants to ride up, sometimes it stays to the bottom. Excuse me. The tire wear hasn't been real bad at all. As I recall, they're pitting now. We go about six more laps, so yeah, we'll be plenty good to make it. And since we are in the championship hunt, we are going to stay out and get those bonus points if we can get them.
Go get these two in front now.
Big gains on them. Actually, we're only 3.7, but it looks like it's because they're stuck in traffic. Biff and the Burke. Just staying high. Looks like Brad's pulling off. It's weird seeing him sucking so bad. But the longer these two stay out, and they have to deal with this lap traffic, we're gaining. Definitely like the odds of us coming out close to the lead, if not in the lead. Stayed a little extra high, just in case they slid up or wrecked each other. And there's our five bonus points.
We
go about three more laps. Don't want to pit this next one. I don't understand why they're all so short. Some of them are pitting real early, unless they can make it on one. I don't want to cheese out a back-to-back victory, but I mean.
31, 34, 1.
I mean, would the AI do me a favor? I know there's some tracks they can go farther than I can, or their tires don't wear like mine do, so it's like, should I take advantage of it? I guess.
Side, clear.
It'd be a bit of a nightmare to try to pit right this second anyway.
Stay high.
Considering I've got Tony Stewart under me.
Alright,
this is the lap we're coming in.
34, 34, 8.
We're gonna go 4. You know, come to think about it, I think we pit on a two-tire stop last season when we spun. That might have been what contributed to our loss of grip coming into turn 1.
Lock side. Clear.
Slow down.
45. Easy.
I don't know where the commitment line is. Oh, shoot. I sped a little bit too much there. I think we have it slowed down enough where we're not going to get penalized.
44. 6. 8. 9.
Oh, God. If we get black flagged. No black flag. I'm purposely keeping it like 3 miles an hour slower and hoping that we don't get it. Yes, okay. At one point I know I was doing like 49 on pit road. I was like, oh god. So we had to slow her up a little bit.
You're clear.
Probably went slower than I needed to, and we're probably gonna pay for it on the track, but I feel like that was way less of a penalty than if we actually got a black flag.
Halfway this time.
Where are we gonna come out?
1, 7, 1, 6, 3.
Second? How did we do that? We're only a second ahead of Biffle and Burton. So they're probably gonna catch us quick, but we're 2.5 behind David Reagan, which is about where we came in. Where we were at when he came down pit road. So I'm also kicking around the idea. So some races, obviously, they're like really bright sunny days or something. So I want to try some stuff with reshade. I love the preset we have. And the link should be in the description where the one I'm using. I might tweak it though for certain races, just a little bit, add some stuff. Like there's a flare feature. Or a flare setting. I would like to kind of, it's like, I feel like it would just look really good at a night race with like blinded light almost like flashing off cars or something. I don't know, I have to see what it looks like, but we did add bloom for this race. To see if it, how it might look. But I kind of want to try to tweak with it a little bit. The setting I used in like the 07, 06, all those seasons, those were my own settings I had messed with, but they didn't look real enough for me. And when I saw the ones that we are currently using, I was like, I gotta have that set. It looks good. It would also look real good if we can reel in the 6 car, because the 16 and 29 are coming. We're only a half second ahead of Greg. We're 2.92 behind Reagan. Side by side behind us, so that should give us a little bit of a gap. Now that's David Reagan right ahead of us. I thought he was 2 cars up. So we can see the leader. That's good. 2.7, so we gained 2/10. I think I know why we gained it though. It's because we're getting draft help from behind. Yeah, we are really arrow. No, I don't know if the physics were that good on this or not, but now that I can feel their draft from behind, I am getting a little bit on the free side once I get back on the accelerator towards the center of the corner. So I just gotta be mindful of that. I don't think we really had anybody coming up behind us like that so far this race. And staying there. So I just gotta get on the accelerator just a little bit easier than I have been. That'll be alright. Try a wider approach to see if we can kind of not have so much of that draft effect going in. That seemed to work really well that turn. And David getting held up by a lap. We're coming. Wider line definitely helped. Not feeling that loose when I, loose on acceleration. My tires were screaming there. I turned down just a little bit later than I'd like to have, so I had to turn it a little harder. Maintaining with Biffle. He's only a half second behind us. Get a good run here on JC Keller. Just go to the outside.
36 inside. Stay high.
Since we haven't run it up there.
Clear, clear.
And hopefully he'll slow down those other two a little bit. So that'll be good. Looks like Eric McClure is holding up. Yeah, he's holding him up big time. He is got a lot of on the front stretch. We got a ton of draft on that straightaway. Hit the tack under there. We're gonna get a big old run.
Outside. Here.
Yeah, we're gonna fly right past him. Go
clear
to
all
the
around.
Wall,
all
dude.
Clear. Outside.
Doing. It's blocking.
Clear all around. All clear.
Oh man. definitely felt that loose effect from someone behind us. Right there.
Oh,
I think stayed high.
No pressure out back. We'll keep you posted.
I don't think he'll make the distance.
Stay high. Clear all around, all clear.
No. Alright. Yeah, when I run towards the bottom, I can't mat it down again. Like I said, there's so much grip at this track. You don't really have to.
Yeah, that'll give us 20 to go.
It'd be too easy to get higher accelerator. You can really get back into it, but someone is like, when I have traffic somewhere from behind, and I go to step on it, it just gets kind of loose if I get on it too quick on the bottom, but when I'm running up a little bit higher, I'm not having that much of an issue. I am very anxious at the thought of what the cup cars are going to run like here, though, with those truck physics, because it has been a hell of a season. Like, the most boring of them all was actually the truck race at California. And I mean, it had good pack racing, don't get me wrong, it was just the most spread out of all the pack races we've had this season. But Daytona for cup and trucks. Now, even nationwide was pretty good, but California cup racing was amazing. Biffle died. Apparently he's come back, you know, he's come back to life and everything. We have a really good health benefits over at RFY Racing in the Truck Series, so we brought him back. But the Atlanta race in the Truck Series, that was a lot of fun. That was really good racing. First to 43rd was like 5 seconds. It was incredible. So I'm very curious to what cup cars are going to be like here at Las Vegas. And it looks like with Reagan, we're just kind of maintaining 0.6 of a second lead. And then it's 1.5 back to Biffle, 1.6 to Burton. And then 12 seconds back to 5th place, Kelly Myers, Kevin Harvick, Carl Edwards, David Rudiment. Forget who Kay Davis is. Ooh. Oh well. And then 10th place is Bobby Labonte. Anybody out? Nah, nobody's out. Just do lap cars. Car did not want to turn there. Curious what this lap time will be. 0.6 slower than that lap. I was starting to wonder, because it felt like it got off the corner pretty quick. I was like, oh, did we find something on the top? I have a feeling we will be up pretty high up to that wall for our next race here in the Cup Series. I believe we came in here trailing Carl Edwards for the point lead. So that will not be an issue after this race. Because I don't even think Carl Edwards is in this race. Oh no, he is. When did we pass him? The 7th. I don't remember even passing Carl Edwards. I honestly thought we were going to probably hit the wall there. Felt like it started to snug up, but I was curious if I could stay in it. Sure enough, it did not hit the wall. After California, I'd say California this season, as long as we're running truck physics and the ratings are as consistent as the seasons are, California definitely moved up on my list of favorite tracks to race at. Not because I like the track, but I just liked the racing that we had. Vegas is definitely one of my favorites. never thought in a million, billion years I'd say Las Vegas is one of my favorites, but through this career, I've really grown to like the Las Vegas Motor Speedway. So it feels good to be able to get... We got some damage. I think it's the first damage we've had all year. Like that. Let me specify. By this point, I imagine seeing the cup race. We did get, you know, it's spinning back into the wall, and we had another incident there. So we've had damage, but first time I've ever come off the turn and popped the wall and damaged it, I feel like. I also like Martinsville. So, there are certain tracks that we're just going to have to stick with the original Papyrus versions. Martinsville will be one of them going forward. At the end of the 07 season, if you saw the 16, 17, something like that, caution flags, race, God love you. That video was so short because there was 66 laps of yellow flags. Like, it was just a nightmare. And any time, I feel like, I haven't really found a good Martinsville outside of Papyrus version, so we're just going to be sticking with some Papyrus tracks. Probably,
clear all around, all clear.
Well, definitely Martinsville for the time being.
Side.
Adam on YouTube.
Still there.
It's now ACR Racing. I think his last name is Caldwell. Adam Caldwell. But he's doing a lot of tutorials, just videos showing how he changes the track signage and stuff like that. And so we could probably dabble with that and update some things at some point.
Clear. Side.
To update the happy tracks.
Still there.
I'm definitely gonna have to find out him at some point. I could have gone 3 wide there, but
still there.
We have a 3-second lead.
Still there.
Don't know how we didn't turn ourselves there.
Still
so
there.
I'm not gonna
clear
push
all
it,
all
but
clear.
We might have to soon. Cars are pitting. Dang it. That's probably what happened to Reagan.
Side.
We can go the distance.
There.
I mean, we're only 5 laps
clear,
off.
All clear.
Oh, wait. It's telling me I need a splash. I'm not going to make it. Now I'm really confused. Are we not gonna make this something? It's saying I need a splash.
Still there, 3 wide, inside. Clear all around, all clear.
That doesn't seem right. I thought we had it, but we were gonna be fine. Unless because we've had draft and stuff like that, we burned up more. I ain't even making this up. You can look at my fuel gauge. You'll see it'll turn yellow soon.
31, 4, 1, 5.
Still staying splash. It's really bizarre. Cause it said none, like just a few laps ago. Still staying splash.
31, 4, 1, 3.
Stand high to avoid any trouble. AI merchant in case they wreck each other. But it looks like we're gonna cycle to a second round of pit stops and we won't have a caution. Which is okay by me. I like green flag racing. Way more fun. We got the field. left.
Clear right there, two to go. Side, side, still there.
I'm gonna feel like crap.
Clear all around, all clear.
You hear the spotter. We're gonna splash and go. I'm gonna be fair. I feel like we can definitely still get him with a splash and go.
45.
And we are monitoring that speed limit. 45.
Do not speed.
I know. I know, spotter. We're good.
You got him, buddy. Come on.
Yeah, come into the white flag. Come in for a splash of fuel that you don't need.
44, 46. There you go. Go, go,
Papers.
Go.
45. Oh my god. My... Wow. My hearts are racing.
Dig hard.
They thought they were repairing damage. Alright, we gotta get off this. Should just turn.
You're clear.
Wow, we're loose. Is that the sixth car? No.
Outside. Clear.
Alright. We made a pit stop, so no one can say it's because we cheesed the AI. We got it. Right?
Woo!
Okay.
All right, we won!
Awesome. So we'll get the win over Jeff Burton, Greg Biffle, David Reagan, Kelly Byers, Kevin Harvick, Bob Labonte, Brad Baker, Kay Davis. Is that Cletus Davis? And then Carl Edwards.
Man, that's good.